For about as long as most of us have been alive, the Academy Awards have had what we'll call a predicament. Namely, that a lot of the movies that get nominated and or win Best Picture are stuff that almost no one saw. While really popular movies often get ignored, all part of a mutually destructive back and forth between a lot of Oscar voters being, well, film snobs, and a lot of the movie-going public being, what's the word? Idiots. This came to a head last year, when the biggest hit of the year, which was also really good and got really good reviews for a change, wasn't even nominated. Something had to be done. So this year, Oscar changed the rules. Instead of 5 Best Picture nominee slots, there are now 10, a move specifically designed to allow well-reviewed blockbusters, genre films, and other stuff that would previously have just fallen short of making the cut to get in. So now, along with the kind of pseudo-highbrow important films that would have been nominated anyway, like Precious, An Education, A Serious Man, The Hurt Locker, and Up in the Air, there's also now room for high-quality hits like District 9, Up, and Inglourious Basterds. What's ironic is that this year they probably didn't need the rule change to allow a genre blockbuster onto the list, since Avatar turned out to be the biggest story of the year and a surefire nominee all on its own. The backlash is gonna bitch about its nomination anyway, but if you really want to see a movie that's only here because it made money, look no further than The Blind Side, an inexplicably popular bucket of feel-good unicorn piss in which Aaron Brockovich uses magical white people powers to turn radio into Rudy, or something like that. Yuck. But it's all good as far as I'm concerned, because, sweet Christmas, District 9 is a Best Picture nominee! Awesome! It's not gonna win, of course. As it stands right now, this looks like a two-horse race between Avatar and Hurt Locker. Neither of them are better than District 9, or Up, or Bastards, or Serious Man, for that matter, but Oscar tends to love a narrative, and this is one hell of a narrative. It's the big, huge fantasy movie versus the small, gritty, realistic movie. They're both topical War on Terror movies. Oh yeah, and Hurt Locker director Catherine Bigelow is Avatar director James Cameron's ex-wife. Now that's a show. They're also both nominated for Best Director, which, like all the other categories, still has only the traditional 5 slots, alongside Quentin Tarantino, Lee Daniels, and Jason Reitman. Doesn't look like there's a lot of suspense here. Bigelow is almost definitely gonna win. She's well-liked in the business, everybody digs the angle of a female director best known for making badass guy movies, and she'd be the first woman ever to win the prize. Plus, it'd clear the way for Oscar to still honor the little movie that could, like Hurt Locker, even if it still ends up giving the top prize to Avatar, which, given its astonishing popularity and that, hey, look, we like big stuff too, is kind of the theme of this year's show, is looking pretty likely at this point. Hell, even I'll admit that after the long ghettoization of sci-fi and fantasy by the Academy, Star Wars never won, 2001 didn't win, Indiana Jones never won, Blade Runner didn't win, E.T. didn't win, Spider-Man, Batman, and Superman all denied, Lord of the Rings had to try 3 times to win, it'd be pretty friggin' great to see Best Picture awarded to a movie that can be roughly described as Thundercats versus Robotech. If nothing else, it's good to have some kind of tension in at least 2 categories, because the others aren't set up for a tremendous amount of surprises. Basically, all of the 4 acting races were probably sewn up months ago. Christoph Waltz is going to win Best Supporting Actor for playing Hans Landa in Bastards. Monique is going to win Supporting Actress for playing the psycho-abusive mom in Precious. Jeff Bridges is finally going to win Best Actor for Crazy Heart after having been overlooked for decades, which is going to make the advertising for Tron 2 really interesting. I'm sorry, I just can't help myself for a divergent for a moment. There's going to be a Tron 2! Yeah! Sorry. If nothing else, having things so sewn up helps alleviate some of the sting from the bigger snubs. Melanie Laurent really should be up for Bastards, Michael Stuhlbarg is being completely ignored for Serious Man, and Neil Blomkamp should have been recognized for directing District 9. And, yes, Sandra Bullock is probably going to win Best Actress for The Blind Side, probably less for the performance itself and more as an industry-wide thank you for all the money pulled in by her terrible, 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 terrible movies. On happier notice, Quentin Tarantino and Jason Reitman are both looking like heavy favorites for Best Original Screenplay and Best Adapted Screenplay, respectively. We could speculate on the technical awards, but let's face it, those have all already been FedExed to Pandora. Hey, do you remember when Halle Berry won an Oscar? Well, Oscar sure hopes you don't. Anyway, the big night is about a month away, so we'll find out then. The show kicks off on March 7th. Steve Martin and Alec Baldwin will be hosting. I'll be, partying. See you next time.